This is a fairly new story. It's about a month old. There once was a baron who hatched a wicked plot. He forged a document that seemed to prove his neighbor and rival was guilty of treason, which he then caused to be sent to the king. The king believed this false evidence and sent his guard to apprehend the rival. After his neighbor's execution, the baron obtained the document he had forged, intending at first to burn it. Instead, he found himself erasing the writing from it, and in a panic, placed it in the basket of one of the king's laundresses. He returned home. Having eliminated his neighbor, the baron began to send his men to occupy and administer the lands adjoining his own. Yet barely a fortnight later, a noble young man and his sister came to the baron's home, claiming to be the cousins of the late rival, who had traveled from the neighboring kingdom. Although the baron had never heard of these relatives, the young man did offer a ring carved with a griffin as black as ebony, the rival's seal, and demanded, "Why have you encroached upon my land?" The baron replied, "I did no such thing. I only sent my men to assist people bereft of their lord until the king could decide what is proper." While the young man was not quite convinced, he could not prove his suspicions. The baron, thinking quickly and wishing to salvage what influence he could, said, "I have 3 children of marriageable age, 2 sons and a daughter. I would be pleased to give you my daughter in marriage and to have your sister marry my oldest son. After all, we are neighbors and can benefit each other greatly." The young man agreed to this proposal, and a great feast was held, platters full of food and free-flowing wine. The document was drawn up the next day, the finest inks and the richest of tinctures being used. That night, the baron's oldest son, somewhat inebriated after yet another feast with free-flowing wine, decided to toast his future bride from the top of the tower. A throng gathered below, laughing and calling words of encouragement, and to their horror, the young man misjudged his step and fell to his death. The baron, retiring to his chamber, was astonished to find the marriage document on his bed. To his horror, other words began to appear behind the agreement, the very words the baron had written to rid himself of his rival. Then both sets of words faded, leaving only the following: "One son has met death. How many more for your crime?" The baron realized to his horror that somehow the parchment his scribe had used was the one he had hidden in the laundress's basket. He fell senseless to the floor. When he awoke, the only words to be seen were the words of the marriage agreement between the 2 young couples. It was the baron's oldest son who was being prepared for burial. His rival's cousin came to him, proposing that his younger son marry in his brother's place. The baron agreed, insisting that a new document be drawn up immediately and the original destroyed. In a few days until his son's funeral, the baron realized his people had begun to whisper of a curse on his family, brought on by some evil. He began to remove himself often from company, keeping a dagger with him lest someone should discover his deed and attack him. A few days before the double wedding was to take place, the baron's daughter was leaving her chamber to join her father in the hall. At the top of the stairway, her braid caught on a hook. In her haste to free herself, she lost her balance and fell down the stairs, her neck snapping. Again, the grief-stricken baron retired, only to find again the marriage document, and again his forged document appeared behind the newer words. A new message appeared: 2 children have met death. Keep my lands and lose your son. Admit your crime and save your son." Slowly, the baron left his room to return to the great hall.